Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for Fun, and today we are back in Eclipse here programming some more on our talent defense game. So I got an email a few days ago by this guy. He wondered whether we would upload this to the internet, you know, basically create an exe file. And yes, we will in the future. That is pretty darn simple. I have created two programs right here. I've created a lot more programs, but these are both ext files, and you know, it takes a second to create them basically. So yeah, we will do that. It is pretty darn simple, and we will of course upload this game to the internet as well, or I will. You cannot upload the same as me, but you know, you can change the towers and change the game a little bit, but do not upload the same as me, because I do not give you rights to do that. And of course, if you have any questions about what you can do and what you cannot do, you know, just email me or send me a message on YouTube, and you know, I'll answer you. So today we are in our tower defense game. Let's open up our screen here, and let's just test it out. I am not sure where we've been, and I'm sorry, you know, for the lack of tutorials lately. Okay, so I do not believe you can see the entire screen. I can though. So yeah, I think for the sake of this video, we will, because I'm not recording my entire screen, I'm just recording a tiny bit of it, three quarters, I'm not sure. But let's change the size of this. You can do this by if you do set extended state, that basically means that it goes to the end of the screen on all sides here, so that it basically goes full screen. And if you want it full screen, you should have it undecorated, or unless it will basically, some of it will be down under your screen or view basically. So yeah, but we can set the size by doing so. This basically sets the size for us, you know. But we can also set the size ourselves. That means that we need to remove this, and then we basically should go only where I'm currently recording, because I'm recording in 1280 pixels by something else, 720. So yeah, but last time we added so that we can have a selected tower. Now I think we will work on so that we can click this tower, which would be pretty darn swell, because then we can basically choose which tower we want to select. So let's jump into our screen class here, and we've already created this method place tower. This is basically place tower. Let's get down here. Is it place tower? This basically gets the X on the screen and Y on the screen. Okay. Now on the screen, that basically means on your entire screen, okay? This is not where your cursor is at your application, but rather on your own screen. So yeah, that's why we're doing it undecorated, because if it is decorated, it kind of counts, so this is a part of the pixel. So yeah, that's why I like creating my games full screen. You can of course use you know, some other you know, methods to make sure that what you're able to see is 800, for example, by 600. It's a little bit hard to explain, but just for the sake of it, if you are not in entirely full screen right now, I am not. If I play this game, it is not actually in full screen, because I'm only recording 3/4 of my screen. So outside of this blue border right here is basically my own screen. So my application is not totally full screen. So yeah, this will not do anything at all, other than make sure that if you do not have full screen, this is better basically. But yeah, it does not affect anything at all elsewhere. So let's make sure that we get working on the clicking. Because this is basically when the mouse is down and the hand is not equal to zero, that basically means that we have something in our hand, because if it is equal to zero, you know, then there is nothing in our hand. So this basically means that we have something in our hand. Now, if we do not have anything in our hands, we can do else. If we do not have anything in our hand and we click, we can basically do something like call a method called select tower, and we want to give it the e.get x. Let's do the normal x, and we want to give it the e.get y. We'll create this method later. Minus frame height border. This is if you are not on a a normal 16:9 screen. So let's create the method select tower, shall we? Down here, public void select tower. There we go. We are giving it an integer of x and integer of y, and this is basically where our tower is. So it will be pretty much like the place tower. Place tower method right here. This is basically placing a tower. But what we can do here, this checks if it is equal to zero. So what we can basically do is we can copy this. I have explained all of this code in a earlier video. So yeah, you can just check that out. It should be labeled something nice as tower place. I'm not sure what I labeled it. But yeah, so we can delete the what's in here. So what this basically means is we are creating a x position and a y position divided by tower size. That basically means that we're counting squares, so one square, two squares, and three squares, instead of, for example, 25 and 50 and 75. So we're basically, pressing that number down using our tower screen variable, which is changed. It depends on your screen size. And now we're basically checking that we are inside of the game area, basically. If we are, or basically if we are not inside of the game, this basically means this method right here, it checks if we are inside of this square right here. Okay? So it checks if we are inside of here. We're basically saying more than zero. That basically means that if it is zero, and zero is basically this border right here. So this is zero on x and y, zero right here, which basically means that it checks if we're more than zero. So if we are outside of this border right here is the same as a tower size, as tower square, or doohickey size. So yeah. Now if we are not on not inside, if we do not click inside of it, we are pretty sure, okay, you cannot place any tiles outside of the area. So I'm pretty sure I can say that selected tower is equal to null if you do not click on any tower, and you're not clicking on any tower at all if, I'm not sure what to say. But this right here, this basically checks if there are no tower at all at tower map right here. And map, what is map? It's a long time since I used this. It's initialized up here, is it? This is basically the map. Okay, is this a integer of let's get down here. This is basically the grid. Okay, so yeah, this is basically the textures. So why are we basically checking that? But okay, I do not care. If this is so, selected tower is equal to null as well, because this basically means if we do not hit any tower at all, we're basically, not hitting a tower at all. What we can actually do is we can set the selected tower here equal to tower map x position and y position. Okay? Selected tower, there we go, because this means that if there are no tower at all, it will leave us with a zero or a null. Basically it will set selected tower equal to null. So yeah, I think that should work. So right now I can place down a tower like so, and I can hit here, and the tower is no longer selected. I can hit outside of this box and I can hit the tiles to select them. Okay, so we're clicking closer and closer. So yeah, it's 1 pixel difference basically. So yeah, it works pretty darn well. We can select the tiles we want to select if we so wish. You know, it's pretty darn swell. Hopefully you get it. And now we'll fix a little bit on this GUI or what you might call it later, because this is not looking the way I want it to look. This is not coded, you know, basically the way I want it to be coded. So we'll fix that later. But for now, let's add this screen Meduheki right down here, shall we? So we know that. Well, where is this? Paint method right here. We are, basically painting out the grid, 22 squares by 14 squares. Now, under here, we can also paint our upgrade menu. Okay, so let's paint the upgrade menu. Let's you do d.setColor. We do not need to set the color because we already set the color to gray up here. It is not changed under here, but just for the sake of it, if you place it in another place, we need to set the color to gray. So we are going to draw a big rectangle, I think. So g.draw rectangle. A normal rectangle. This will have a XY with a height. Now, the X position, this is pretty darn simple. We know that we have... let's just comment this out before we run it, or we will not be able to run it. Come on. Okay, so we got squares here, right? Okay, so this is in the way. What? Come on! Okay, who cares? So we got one square here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and you know it's 22 squares over the entire space right here. And we got one here, so that basically means 23 spaces. And we'll probably add some a space around here as well, So the X position will basically be let's cast the tower size to an int here. Tower size to an int. Let's multiply this by 24. We got a border on the left side. We got 22 in the middle and a border on the right side, which basically is 24. Or 22 plus 1 plus 1 is 24. The Y position will be only tower size. Let's cast that as well to an int. The width will basically be... what will the width be, actually? We know that the height... Well, the width will basically be the width minus tower size multiplied by 25 this time, because we have a border on the right side as well. Now, how do we access this? We got a variable up here called frame, do we not? Yes, we do have a variable called frame, so that should be pretty swell. So let's just do frame dot. Did we actually set to static? No, we did not. So let's just do frame dot get width. There should be a method in there for get width. And we're going to do minus. Let's cast an int tower size, and let's multiply this by 25, because you got a border on the left side, which is 1, plus 22, which is 23, plus one border here, which is 24, and a border on the right side. So we're basically taking the entire screen, minus everything on the left side here, and a border on the right side, which is 25 squares. The height, this will basically be equal to frame... Oh, what am I doing? I'm outside of the area here. The height will be equal to frame dot get height. We're going to do minus. No, we're not going to do minus here. We're not going to do frame at all. We are going to cast an int tower size. Oh, spell it correctly. Tower size multiplied by 14. Because 14 is the size of our map, basically. Our map here is 14 high. So yeah, that's why we're setting 14 there, which should leave us with a nice little square, hopefully at least. Yes, here we go, a nice square. So if I set this size in our frame here to be less, like something like 300 by 720, this will look so awful. So yeah, as you can see, it will automatically generate our window here is 300 by 720, and it will create this into a 720 pixel area, basically, or a 16 to 9 area, sorry. So here we go, this is our Meduheki. Oh! So you can see here, it's good we tested, because we got this square up here, which is not where we want it, but this is looking working pretty dance well. It is a very little area here, but it is working, as you can see. This area, so it should work on all screens, our text here, and this down here is not finished, of course, but this box right here is placed in the not correct area. Because the Y here, we're just setting equal to tile size, but we also want frame height border. Now, what is frame height border? Well, basically, I've explained this a lot of times before this, but frame height border is basically this black border on top of our window. If you have a 16 to 9 screen, you will not get any border at all, but if you do not, it will basically create a 16 to 9 screen. So yeah, now it should be in the correct place, because frame height border is basically this black border on top here. Beautiful. So, what do we want in this upgrade menu? Well, I have no idea how it will look, but let's first of all change this back to 1280, because that basically means that everything will be a little bit bigger again. Here we go. As you can see, we got our border Meduheki. Now, I have no idea how this will look like. We'll probably have a picture, a bigger picture up in here, and then we'll probably add some kind of name to this tower, and how many towers this is, how many enemies this have killed, and stuff like that as well. So yeah, let's create a picture this episode. Let's just do it. Let's do g.drawImage. No, let's actually draw a rectangle first, shall we? Draw rectangle, just to outline everything. And we will draw this rectangle. How big will this rectangle be? Well, first of all, we can set the size, the X position, rather. It will be the same X position as this one right here. Only it will be, whatchamacallit, we'll basically add int and then tower size. Let's cast out tower size to an int here. We'll basically add half of a tower size, basically. So there we go, that's the X position. Let's add the Y position, which should be int. Let's cast tower size to an int here. Tower size, there we go. We're going to add frame height border, just so you know, if people are not on a 16 to 9 screen. And we're also going to add as well int tower size multiplied by divided by 2. Okay. Now another way to do this. Well, let's just finish this method, shall we? And on the height. No, the width. No. The width will be equal to. No, this is the height. Why? Okay, my bad. The height. Now the width. Sorry. Will be equal to, well, let's first of all grab the normal width here, and we will set this equal to, tower size is changing, because, you know, we want this to be able to change as well, so let's do three tower sizes, that basically means that we need to have the same on the Y here. Because, you know, our towers are squares. We can test this out. So yeah, we got a square, you know, here. And in here, our image will be, basically. Which is swell. Now, what we should do is we should do -1 on the X position. And -1 on the Y position. and we're going to do on the width plus 2 and on the height plus 2 as well, which basically means that we will be able to, we're basically switching, you know, we have a square border here, we're moving it 1 pixel to the left, 1 pixel to the right, top, and you know, basically to be able to have this border, this gray border outside of our image. So we can now go down here and do g.drawImage. Let's do this one right here. We're going to choose the image of selected tower dot selected tower dot texture, and at the X position we can basically copy from here, we can basically copy everything that's in the absolutely everything inside of our draw rectangle. Let's add this in here. Let's close this one and let's do a comma null. Now this time we'll remove the plus 2 on the height, plus 2 on the width, and minus 1 on the X and Y position, which will leave us with a nice gray border outside of our image. So, come on. Oh, my bad. There we go. Come on. It is loading up, I believe, or it crashed. I'm not sure. Oh, it crashed. Why? Okay, so it might be null. Sorry. We did forget to check, so we can do this in a one line. So if selected tower is not equal to null, just check that, and we'll move this a little bit further out, and that should be it. You just need to make sure to spell this correctly. Just add this line of code right here. You do not need to open it or anything at all if you have on one line, which is pretty swell. Now it should not crash. There we go. No selected tower at all, so this is not selected, but when I put this tower in here, we get our tower up in here, and when I do not, you know, unclick it, you know, it is beautiful. Yeah, our tower defense game is coming along. We do have, of course, some bugs still that we need to fix and talk and work around. We will also have to add a kind of box down here as well, which will probably be the start game, and probably a speed up and stuff like that as well. So yeah, but that will have to be for the next episode, everybody. I'm sorry, but that's just how it is. It's taking a little while, you know, to create stuff when you're trying to explain everything that's going on, and you're not very good at explaining stuff. But yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I'm going to try my best to create many more, you know, in the upcoming weeks. I know I've been a little bit lazy lately, but yeah, I'll do my best. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, everybody. My name is ScratchFun, and I'll catch you all guys in my next week. Goodbye.